Hi, welcome to the Dynamics Tutorials. So for this problem, we have a wheel that's rolling without slipping. The center of gravity here is G. The point where it contacts the surface is A. This is the point where it's rolling without slipping. And then we have point B over here that's at a 30 degree angle out on the radius. The radius of the wheel is 0.4 meters, and we need to find the velocity at the center of gravity, the velocity at A, and then also the velocity and acceleration at point B if it is rolling without slipping. Because it's rolling without slipping, we can go ahead and just apply the rolling without slipping formulas. So the velocity at G is equal to omega. Our omega in this case was 2 radians per second times the radius of 0.4. That gives us 0.8. We know that the velocity of the center of gravity is going to be going in this direction if it's rolling in this direction. So we get 0.8 meters per second. The acceleration of the center of gravity is going to be equal to just alpha r, again from the rolling without slipping formulas. And so we have our alpha of 0.5 times a radius of 0.4, which gives us an acceleration of the center of gravity of 0.2. It's also going to be in the I direction because we have the alpha acceleration going in this direction. The velocity of point A is going to be equal to zero because A is the instantaneous center. It's where it contacts the ground. And so if it's not slipping, it must be moving the same speed as the ground. The ground's stationary, so it must be stationary at A. The acceleration at A, we can develop that as the acceleration at G plus alpha cross the position vector from A to G minus omega times the position vector from A to G. So it gives us this vector equation here. Doing the vector arithmetic gets us to this line. And then when we're done, we get 1.60 J meters per second squared. And that would make sense because this A is being pulled upward in order to complete the circle. So everything should be moving upward at that point. So velocity at B, we can develop this as the velocity at the center of gravity plus omega cross the position vector that goes from G out to B. So here's our equation. Notice with all of these, this is two-dimensional motion. So both the alpha, the angular acceleration, and the omega term, the angular velocity are going to be in the k direction. These are also both clockwise, so they're going to both be negative k vectors. The position vector from G to B is going to be the 0.4 meters radius times the cosine of 30 degrees plus the 0.4 meters radius times the sine of 30 degrees in J. So doing the vector arithmetic here, that gives us the 1.2i minus 0.693 J meters per second for the velocity at B. So B is moving in this direction and also down. That would make sense as this wheel rotates. B is still moving forward, but it's also got to start going down at that point. Double checking this, it should also give us a direction of B that would be in the tangential direction that point's going to be going in. The acceleration at B is going to be the acceleration at G plus alpha cross R from G to B minus the omega squared times the position vector starting at G and going up to B. And so here's our vector equation, and then reducing that down, that gives us negative 1.09i minus 0.973 J meters per second squared. Thanks for watching.